The last thing that I want to quickly point out about content delivery networks that's maybe not so much of a positive, that's tricky, is we've been talking about sending data from the server to all of these web browsers. But how do we handle when the browsers are returning data to us? As an example, if we're talking about a site like Reddit or a blog with comments, where a popular blog with comments, where the users are generating data and sending it back to the server. Now we've got connections between, say, this browser and this local server right here. But if we want to put that data into the database that we've got here, then how does that get propagated back to this master database, much less all of the other databases that are around? That is a non-trivial, very tricky situation to deal with. It is not very easy to do. And some solutions are that content delivery networks are only one direction, so they send information out, but anytime they get data, it gets forwarded via a proxy back to the main server. But then if we've got caches at all of these locations, how do those caches know that they're out of date? Others have communications between the databases so that when one part of the database gets updated, others can be notified of it and copy the data around. Still others say that it's okay for the data to be stale for a little bit at one location because the data that's being viewed is not critical. So if you think of, say, Facebook as an example, when you send a post, is it okay that people who are at the same location of you get the data right away, and it takes a while, who knows for whatever reason or how long, before people over here are able to access that same data because it wasn't propagated immediately from this database to this database? Probably. And so that is a way to kind of make things a little bit easier on the content delivery network. But whatever the case is, I want to point out that having these replicated databases or sharded databases, there's a slight difference, either one of them, it is difficult to deal with. Replicated database, real quick, is that if you've got a database, you copy it to all your different locations. So every location has all of the database at each location. Versus a shard or sharding is if we've got our big master database right here, we're going to take a piece of it and we're going to copy that to one of the databases, and we're going to copy a separate piece of it to a different location database. And maybe a third piece of it is copied to another location. And we do this until we've copied all the database to all the different locations. And so this location might have the blue database, the red database, the green database, and so on. And so together they make up the entire database. And this can work, especially if you think of the Olympics scenario, if you expect one region to access one part of the database primarily and to ignore other parts of the database. And so this can be a useful solution. And the databases doesn't exist as a whole in any one place. One part of it's here, one part of it's there, and the total database is the combination of all parts of those. And then you can do combinations of replication and sharding and blah, blah, blah. The key, however, that I want you to get from this is when you start having multiple input locations, this browser over here and that browser over here, all going to different database servers, it gets really complicated very quickly.